Congressman Flores, you're part of the larger U.S. Congressman delegation in Macedonia to discuss about cooperation between Macedonian Parliament and Congress, but you came in a period when the country is focused on referendum after the agreement with Greece. Can you tell me more about all of this, especially about how you see this agreement?
Yes. The House Democracy Partnership is a bipartisan group, and we are here as a group to promote Macedonian accession into NATO and ultimately into the European Union. And so Macedonia already has a vibrant democracy, but we're here to try to help the country go to the next step to show that we as the United States support Macedonian accession and that we're here to do all we can to partner with Macedonia. Let me say this. There is no agreement that's perfect, but what we have to look at is what's the greater good. In this case, the agreement with Greece sets up a path so Macedonia can become a member of NATO and then ultimately, hopefully, become a member of the European Union. This is good for the future of all Macedonians. So for Macedonian families, it means more economic opportunity. It means more national security for the country. It means more domestic investment, more foreign investment, more jobs, greater economic opportunity. And so we think it's a great opportunity for Macedonia to continue to get more integrated in the Atlantic European Alliance.
Congressman Price, during the visit you meet all relevant political representatives in the country. What is your assessment about a political situation ambient in the country before the referendum?
We've been involved as the House Democracy Partnership, our bipartisan commission, for our entire life, the entire life of the commission, which is now almost 12 years. So Macedonia has been a longtime partner and a treasured friend and partner. We've made many visits here. Many Macedonian members of parliament and staff members have come to the U.S. And so we've had a long history of trying to support each other and to develop modern parliamentary institutions for this country and also to learn from Macedonia's experience on our side. No democracy ever quite gets it right. We all have to keep working at it.
Congressman Flores, upcoming referendum, which is closely related to the Macedonian accession membership to NATO and EU, has divided politicians and public in the country on pro and against, and even we have the calls, open calls for the boycott of the referendum. What is your opinion about it?
Well, I think this is the normal democratic process in any initiative that comes up in any country, even at home in the United States. Some people support those initiatives and some people don't. But I think what's important for the Macedonian people is to think about what gives them the best possible outcome. And in our view of the world, the best possible outcome is to have this referendum, to have this path toward an alliance with NATO and possibly accession to the European Union. And so while we can't encourage people to vote one way or the other, we do encourage them to get out and vote because this is hugely important for Macedonia's future.
So you don't think that the boycott is a solution for this?
No, and actually we've met with members of the opposition party and they have said themselves in meetings that they don't think the, not all of them of course, but some of them have said that they don't agree with the boycott, that they think that this issue is too important to rely on a party platform and rather to rely on what's the single best thing that can happen for Macedonia, and that's the path toward accession to NATO. And so I'm really pleased to see the some members of the opposition party say that they were willing to support this and to be against the boycott.
Macedonia got the veto in Bucharest in 2008, despite all previous announcements that the country will get the invitation for the membership. Today, in Macedonia, is some degree of skepticism that the situation can be repeated, even if Macedonia changed the name. What do you think about it?
Well, I remember that. I remember that veto very well. We visited Skopje. Actually a few weeks after that, as I recall. It was about the same time. And we, on a bipartisan basis, expressed our support for Macedonian accession to NATO and not letting this name dispute stand in the way. So it's been a good many years since then. It's, I know, been a hard road, but it's good to see this coming together the way that it has. And we are hopeful that that this will finally be resolved, and that the NATO accession will be concluded. You know, Macedonia is a small country, but we have thought from the very beginning, and this is the reason we chose Macedonia as a partner early on. We think it is an extremely important keystone of the Balkan region. And to have instability here or to have problems here could mean problems elsewhere. So it is in all of our interest, I believe, for this to be resolved in a positive way. Looks to me as if we've gone past the days of the veto. I mean, you have a Greek agreement. We have a path forward here, and we're of course not going to tell Macedonians how to vote, but we are trying to express, and we're doing this on a bipartisan basis. I don't think there's any disagreement that I know of within our Congress about the desirability of having Macedonia as a full participating member of NATO and integrated into the West. It can be a really important moment in Macedonian history and in European history, and we hope the opportunity won't be missed.
Congressman Flores, the State Department said that the solution on the name issue, name dispute between Macedonia and Greece, is part of the U.S. geostrategy against Russian influence in Europe. Do you see Russian interference in Macedonia, and in which way?
Yes, we believe that Russia is interfering with the referendum process. If you think about it, the Russians don't want to increase the size or the scope or the importance of NATO. And so, of course, they're interfering. But I think what's important for the Macedonian people is to look at whether they offer a better alternative. Is it better for Macedonia to look to the east, or is it better for Macedonia to look to the European Atlantic Alliance? And I think for most Macedonians, they're very smart, and I think they understand that their future security, their future economic development, the future opportunity for their families is to look to the European Atlantic Alliance and to look past the noise that comes from Putin's Russia.
Mr. Price, could this interference harm the referendum or maybe a future Macedonian accession to NATO?
I think the interference is potentially very harmful. It's disappointing that Mr. Putin seems to think a country like Macedonia can't have friendly relationships all around. We understand that Macedonia is in a difficult neighborhood and needs to have friendly relationships to the east, but we also understand that most Macedonians believe their future is with Europe, and that they have a critical role in stabilizing this part of Europe and in being an example of democracy for the rest. That seems a very bright future. It's too bad the Russians feel like they want to try to derail it. I hope and believe they won't succeed.
And the last question is for both of you. Are you optimistic that Macedonia will take the last step towards membership in NATO?
Absolutely.
Yes, I'm quite confident in that. We understand this referendum is an important first step, but it looks like NATO's ready, right? I mean, NATO seems to be welcoming and ready, and so that, I hope, offers encouragement to the Macedonian people.
Congressman Flores, Congressman Price, thank you for the interview.
Thank you.